Every liter of water you can produce on the moon's surface will save about $1 million in transporting it there from Earth. Water will play a significant role in helping astronauts return to the moon and then to Mars. Not just for drinking, water can also be used to grow food, protect against harmful radiation, and make propellant for spacecraft. Water ice will most likely be found in the polar regions of the moon. Here, sunlight strikes the moon's surface at such a low angle that some regions remain in permanent darkness. Temperatures recorded in these permanently shadowed regions are extremely cold. These conditions allow trapped water to remain preserved for billions of years. Although there has not yet been a successful surface exploration mission to the moon's polar regions, we do have data collected by spacecraft orbiting the moon to help us in the search for water. These data sets suggest large deposits of water ice. Despite these positive signs, we are limited in what we know of the characteristics of lunar water with this data. To make decisions about how to use this water and what equipment we need to extract it, we will require a better understanding of how it is distributed on the moon. We do not yet know how widespread or how concentrated it is, whether it occurs only at the surface, or perhaps if there are large stores of ice buried beneath the ground. This is important because without better data, we could be sending astronauts to places drier than the driest deserts on Earth. This work brings together data layers to produce visual displays of the lunar surface. Combined with knowledge of water resource models, we can use this information to create resource prospecting, evaluation, and resource use strategies. This work will not only assist in directing exploration activities to expand our use of space, but will also help us to uncover a little more of the hidden secrets of our closest celestial neighbour. Follow CSIRO as we help get astronauts to the moon and then to Mars.